Assalamu alaikum, dear student. This is lecture number 3 of week number 10. This is probably the last lecture of chapter number 8, viscous flow in pipe. And probably this is the last lecture of the course also, because I have all covered the whole course. And probably after that, I will not upload any video lecture. So let's see the learning objective that we have covered. So we have covered almost all the learning objective, and we are just fulfilling the requirement of this final learning objective, which is apply appropriate equation and principle to analyze a variety of pipe flow situations. So far we have discussed the major losses. Now we are going to discuss the minor losses. We will see the situation where major and minor losses are combined. So that will covered also in this section. To achieve this learning objective, what are the topics we are going to cover today? Are the minor losses and head loss at the inlet of pipe. Head loss in pipe fittings and valves, and practice problem, the numericals we will see. So what is the minor losses? The minor loss occurs locally across the minor loss component. Okay, so what are the minor losses components? The components may be reducer, elbows, may be of a different degree, 45 degree, 90 degree, or 120 degree, but keep in mind that the component influences the flow for several pipe diameter downstream. So the components what you are using, because of that the diameter may vary. Okay, so it depends upon the components what you are installing. Okay, so in this case, this is the reason why most of the flow meter manufacturer recommended installing their flow meter at least 10 to 20 pipe diameter downstream of any elbow or valves. Okay, because we know that after elbow fittings or valves, the flow doesn't remain fully developed laminar or turbulent. Okay, it changes. Okay, so because of that, okay, if the flow enter to the flow meter, we will not get a good or reliable reading. So because of that, after the minor loss component, we install 10 or 20 meter long straight pipe. Okay, till we consider that the flow become fully developed laminar or turbulent. Okay, so in that case, the flow meter, the reading we will get will be almost reliable. Okay, so here the minor losses are also expressed in terms of the equivalent length defined as. Okay, so we can define or we can represent the minor losses in term of the equivalent length. Okay, how it is? Because the head loss of the minor component we can write down like this, because this basically influence the reduction in energy loss. Okay, reduction in velocity. Okay, so this is the loss coefficient KL. Here you can see KL is the loss coefficient, and this is reduction in velocity because of the geometry of the loss component. Okay, so the head loss equal to loss coefficient multiplied by the velocity over 2g. Okay, so if you replace HL with the equation, so this will become this. So here what will happen, v square cancel, 2g will cancel, so equivalent length will be equal to d over f into kl. Okay, so you can convert the loss of energy in the form of equivalent length. Okay, so here the minor losses, the total head loss in a system is comprised of major loss in the pipe section and the minor losses in the components. Okay, so the major losses, basically the pressure drop in the straight pipe, we consider it as a major loss, and the minor loss in the components like fittings and valves are considered as minor loss. Okay, so the net loss is equal to major loss plus minor loss. So here HL is equal to number of straight pipes okay, and number of the minor loss components. Okay, so here if the piping system has constant diameter, okay, so HL will be equal to V square because the velocity will remain constant. Understand now? So in that case, velocity we will take it common, okay, because the cross section area is same. Okay, so here in that case we can calculate the major and minor loss by using this equation. Okay, here you see the head loss at the inlet of the pipe. So head loss basically varies based on the inlet of the geometry. Okay, here you see this is the sharp entrance. Here the loss coefficient is 0.5. Here it is a bit curved, so the loss coefficient is 0.03, is very minimal. Okay, here almost you can see the flow entering to the pipe from the reservoir to the pipe is almost in a streamline. Okay, almost flow in a laminar flow. Okay, and here you can see the when the flow entered the pipe, here you can see there is a cavitation. Okay, there is a turbulence, there is a big turbulence you can see here, and here you see the flow area is reduced. So this reduced flow area is called the vena contracta. Okay, so here we can see the head loss at the inlet of the pipe is a strong function of geometry. You see the geometry is changes, so the head loss varies. It is almost negligible for well rounded inlet. K is equals to 0.03 as it is mentioned, and R by 2 is equals to 0.2, but increases to about 0.5 for sharp edge inlet because as it is mentioned here. Okay, because of, okay, so especially at high velocity, therefore the flow separates at the corners as it is obvious it is mentioned here. The flow is constricted into the vena contracta. Okay, so this is called a vena contracta because the area of the flow is reduced. Here you see the area of flow is increased. Okay, region formed in the midsection of the pipe, so it is formed somewhere here. So let's see, here you can see the sharp edges. This is 0.0, 0.1, 0.3. We can see here how the energy grade line and the pressure grade line varies. Okay, when the fluid enters to the sharp edge area and enter to the pipe. Okay, here you can see at the initial condition the energy grade line and the velocity grade line is same. Okay, the total head and the pressure head is the same. Okay, but as you enter to the pipe, you see there is a sharp decline in the pressure head. Okay, so here as the pressure head is decreasing, okay, but the velocity head is increasing. Okay, so when it reaches to this point, okay, so velocity head is maximum at this point. Okay, the velocity head is maximum as at this point. So because here the vena contracta is less, as the area is less, so velocity is more. Okay, so the dynamic pressure is more. Okay, so as you move forward, you see the area is increasing. As the here you see the static pressure is reduced and the dynamic pressure is increased, but as you are moving forward from the vena contracta, you can see there is a static regain. This static pressure is increasing, as because in the diffuser section when you increase the area, static pressure increases and velocity decreases. So same thing here, you see at point 2 the dynamic pressure is decreasing, okay, and the static pressure is increasing at this point 2. Okay, and here you can see there is a loss coefficient, there is a loss of velocity head because of this sharp edge or because of the viscous flow. If it is a non-viscous flow, the flow remain follow like this, the line follow remain like this. Okay, but since this is a viscous flow, there is a energy loss. Okay, so because this is the loss coefficient, okay, because of this geometry. Okay, so here we have a different type of piping inlet and it has a different loss coefficient as it is mentioned here. Okay, so that we can use during the solution of the problem. And here also you can see the this is the diffuser section, this is the diffuser section. So this is the loss coefficient is equals to 1 minus d square over capital D square. So here you can see the loss coefficient increases as the d square over d square is KL is decreasing as d square over d square is increasing. Okay, so this is basically the reducer. This is basically the expander. It is the dia is increasing from small dia to big dia, and this is basically the reducer, the flow from big diameter to the small diameter, any big cross section area to the small cross section area. In that case, this is for the expansion and this is for the contraction. Okay, so this is loss coefficient is given for the 20 degree, and loss coefficient for the 20 degree is 0.02. okay, and here the loss coefficient is 0.3. okay, so let's move next. So here you see the head loss in the pipe fittings and valves. So these are the different type of fittings. These are the 40 degree elbow, this is the sharp elbow, this is the elbow with the turning vanes. Okay, this is 45 degree elbow, this is a U-turn, this is a T. Okay, this is a reduced T, this is a equal T, and this is a expansion joint or the threaded joint, threaded union. Okay, and here are the loss coefficient given for the different type of valves. Okay, gate valve fully open, fully closed, there is a different loss coefficient is given. So depending on the actual situation, we select the value of loss coefficient. Okay, so here we are going to discuss some of the problems. So here you see the head loss and pressure rise during gradual expansion. We will see, as I said, that during the gradual expansion there is a static regain, that we will see how it is. So here you can see a 6 cm diameter horizontal water pipe expands gradually to a 9 cm pipe. So here you see this is the pipe, okay, gradually increasing to 6 cm, from 6 cm to the 9 cm, because this is the direction of the flow from point 1 to point 2. Okay, so this is basically a expander. Okay, so the walls of the expansion sections are angled 30 degrees. So the angle it is given, it is 30 degree. Okay, from the horizontal, the average velocity and pressure of water before the expansion section is 7 m/s. The velocity is given here, the 7 m/s, and this is the pressure is given here respectively. Determine the head loss. So we have to determine the head loss from here to here in the expansion section, and the pressure in the larger diameter, and here we have to determine the pressure in the larger diameter. So two things we have to determine. One is the pressure drop in the expander and the pressure at point 2. So this is we have to determine. So now we have to make assumptions. The flow is steady and incompressible, the flow at section 1 and 2 is fully developed and turbulent with alpha 1 and alpha 2 is 1.06. so it's up to you how you consider. So instead of considering alpha 1, alpha 2 is 0, we are considering it is 1.06. okay, so it's up to you what you are assuming. Okay, so we take the density of water to be, these are densities are given. Okay, so let's see the what is given. Basically here it is, the meter per second velocity is given. Okay, so here this is the mass flow rate. Noting that the density of water remain constant, the downstream velocity of water is determined from conservation of mass to be. Okay, the density of water remain constant, the downstream velocity, so we can calculate, because if the density is constant, we can use the mass volume flow rate. Okay, so it is given, it is continuity equation. Okay, so q1 is equals to q2, okay, or a1 v1 is equals to a2 v2. So here we can calculate velocity at section v2. okay, so now Then the irreversible head loss in the expansion section. So how we can calculate the head loss? This is the loss coefficient KL for the expander at 30 degree. We should see how much it is. So let's see here, expander. Okay, so this is the expander. We have another table where we can see its values. Okay, so we have another tables you can see in the book, okay, where the loss coefficient for the expander is 0.07. okay, velocity we have calculated at the inlet is 7 meter per second, and this is given. So head loss is 0.175 meter. okay, so noting that the Z1 and Z2, okay, and there are no pumps or turbines involved, the energy equation for the expansion section can be expressed in terms of heads. Okay, so the pressure at the inlet, velocity at the inlet, and the pump at the inlet. So pressure at the exit, velocity at the exit, and the turbine. So we have to, velocity is known now, we have to determine the pressure at the exit. Okay, pressure at the inlet is known, so we put all the values. So this is this one is the same because it's a horizontal reducer. So Z1 and Z2 is same, the same datum line. So no pump, so this is 0, this is 0, and no turbine, this is 0. So finally this will become equal to this. So everything is known, just we have to determine P2. So let's see. So we substitute all the values and finally we got 169 kilopascal. Let's see here. You see the pressure is increased. Okay, initially at P1 the pressure was 160 kilopascal. Okay, but here the pressure is increased, it's 169 kilopascal, but you can see the velocity is reduced. Okay, what was the velocity at the beginning? At the beginning the velocity was 7 meter per second. Okay, but now the V2 is 3.11 meter per second. So this velocity is basically converted in the form of the static regain. Okay, so this is basically the explanation you can find out in this discussion. Let's see another problem that will probably clear our concept. Okay, so here the water at 60 degree Fahrenheit flows from a basement to the second floor through the 0.75 inch diameter copper pipe as drawn tubing at a rate of copper pipe tubing. Okay, at a rate of Q is equals to 12 gallon per minute. This is the flow rate is given, and if you convert this into feet cube per second it will become 0.0267. and let's see so this is the basement and the water is flowing from basement to the second floor. This is the second floor, this is the first floor which has a height 10 feet, and the second floor it has a height 10 feet. Okay, and this is 0.2. so exit through the exit through a faucet of diameter 0.5 inch as shown in the figure. So this is the faucet is shown in the figure. So here you can see in the picture, this is the basement at point 1, okay, and there is a straight pipe of length 15 meter, then it goes up 10 feet, okay, to the first floor, and then there is a elbow 90 degree, and then it moves 5 feet to the straight pipe, and then there is a elbow, and then it goes up to the second floor 10 feet height, and there is a straight pipe, and in between there is a globe valve. Okay, after the globe valve there is a faucet, and the faucet has a diameter 0.5 inches. But throughout the network, the pipe diameter is same, which is 0.75 inches. Okay, so you must keep in mind these unit has to be considered in the FPS system. If it is inches, it has to be converted into feet. Don't use as a 0.75 inches or 0.5 inches. It has to be converted. Okay, and for the faucet, you see the loss coefficient is given, but for the globe valve, you have to calculate the loss coefficient, and for the others, we will see and we will solve the problem one by one. So what we exactly have to do? We have to find out, determine the pressure at point 1. So we have to determine the pressure at point 1. All the losses are neglected. First, don't consider any losses. Then what would be the pressure at this point 1? At in that case, the pressure has to be maximum. Okay, so in the second case, the only losses include are the major losses. So what are the major losses? The losses in the straight pipe, all the losses in the straight pipe are considered as a major loss. So in the second case, we are considering only the major losses in the pipe. In the third case, we have to consider all the losses, the major and minor. In third case, we will consider losses through the fittings, the elbows, and through the valves and faucets. Okay, so in that case, we will see what is the pressure at point one, and in this case, what is the pressure at point one. So let's go step by step. For the first case, what exactly we have to do? We have to determine the pressure at point one. So first we have to determine what kind of flow in the pipe. So to determine the flow in the pipe, we have to go check the Reynolds number. So this is the Reynolds number. To determine, to find out the Reynolds number, we need velocity, diameter, and the fluid properties. The fluid properties are given. Okay, the fluid properties are given. Or if it is not given, so we can go to the table and we can find out. So here we calculated the velocity at point one by using the flow rate which was given. Okay, and the diameter is 0.75 inches. We have converted into feet, and the density of the fluid is given also. Okay, this is all the values are given. So we calculated the Reynolds number, which is the 45,000. Okay, so 45,000 is definitely, it is greater than 4,000. That means the flow is much turbulent, fully turbulent. Okay, so the governing equation, so thus the flow is turbulent. The governing equation for either case A, B, or C is the energy equation is given. So this is the energy equation for all three cases. So we will see. So this L is basically the total losses. Okay, so P1 is the pressure at point one, and P2 is the pressure at point two. Okay, and alpha one is the V1 is the velocity at one, and V2 is the velocity at point two. Okay, the final velocity. Okay, Z1 and Z2 is the elevation at, if this is the datum line, so Z1 is 0 and Z2 is 10 feet is 20 feet. Alpha 1 and alpha 2 is the energy coefficient, okay, kinetic energy coefficient, and we are considering because almost the pipe is straight throughout the network. Okay, only here is the small difference, so we are considering alpha is 1. But if there is a reducer or something in between, so we could consider alpha 1 and alpha 2 as a bigger value. But here, throughout the network, the pipe size is almost the same, so we are considering alpha 1 and alpha 2 are unity. This is the reason, because turbulent velocity profile are nearly uniform across the pipe. Thus, so everything is known, so we can apply all those values to this equation. Okay, so in that case, so this is the equation. So if in the first to solve A, okay, so we put all the values, so we after simplification the equation will become, because here you see, here we have a free jet condition. Okay, in the free jet condition, the P2 is zero because the water is discharging in the atmosphere. So here the pressure is zero. So here we have a velocity V2. So P1 will become gamma Z2. Okay, Z1 is zero. So half V2 minus V1 square. So we have some velocity V1, we have some velocity V2, and gamma HL is the total loss. So in the first case, we are not considering any, neglecting all kind of losses, whether it is minor or major. So HL will be zero in that case. So if HL will be zero, so P1 will become the static head and the dynamic head. Okay, that pressure, if when we after simplifying the calculation, we got the pressure P1 is equals to 10.7 psi. So here we can further elaborate. Note that for this pressure drop, the amount due to elevation change, because the elevation is changing from here to here, so because of that there is a pressure here also. So that pressure is about 8.67 psi, and the amount due to increase in kinetic energy is this, because the velocity is also increasing because the pipe dia is reduced. Okay, so here it is the pressure drop, the pressure head we got is 2.07. So when we add them together, the total pressure in case of no losses, P1 is 10.7 psi. Now the second component. Now the part B. The only losses include are major losses. Yani now we are going to consider losses in the pipe only. Okay, so we know the head loss. Okay, in case of the head loss, we know all the components. So here you can see the part B. If only losses include are the major losses, the head loss is, so this is the major loss, okay, that we can calculate. Okay, so here the pipe diameter is, so we have already determined the flow is turbulent, so we know the Reynolds number, but to calculate the major loss we know the friction factor. To find out the friction factor, what exactly we need two things: relative roughness and the Reynolds number. So Reynolds number we have already determined, okay, and the relative roughness, the pipe tubing is copper pipe, so we can go to the table, we can see the epsilon or the roughness value, and we can divide with the D. So this is the value. Now the relative roughness is known, okay, so now for the Reynolds number 45,000, and this is the relative roughness, we can go to the Moody chart and we can calculate F. So F we calculated, which is 0.0215. okay, so now F is known, D is known. What is L? So L is the total length of pipe, whether it is horizontal or vertical. Okay, so you see the 15 plus 5 plus 10 plus 10 plus 20. So let's go back and see. Here you see 15 plus 10 plus 5 plus 10 plus 10 plus 10, or you can say 20. Okay, so these are the total length of pipe which basically influences the major loss. Influencing the major loss. Okay, so here is the total length of the pipe, which is 60 feet. So we have to calculate the major loss through this 60 feet pipe. So here all P1 is equals to all, everything will be same, only the total head loss will be the major head loss, that will be equal to this value. So we will substitute that value and this will become P is equals to 21.3 psi. So here, so in the case of the major loss, the total pressure drop we get at the inlet of the pipe is this. If we want to maintain the velocity at the exit is which is given, okay, the velocity at the exit we have to maintain is 19.6 feet per second. If you want to maintain this, so the pressure would be 21.3 psi at the inlet. So because of the pipe, how much energy or pressure we are losing, which is basically, you see, 21 is the total pressure drop minus this is the pressure drop due to no losses. Okay, so if you minus this, so this is the pressure drop due to the pipe friction. Okay, due to the pipe roughness, this is the pressure drop we are getting. So this is the total pressure drop at P1. So now in case 2, if we are considering both major and minor losses, so this is the major loss and this is the minor loss. So in this case, this is for the major loss, P1 we have already calculated. Okay, P1 is equal to major loss plus the minor loss. So KL is the loss coefficient for the valves and for the elbows. So how many elbows we have total? We can see total elbows we have, you can see here, total elbows we can see. So we have loss coefficient rho KLV square. Okay, so this is basically rho into density. Okay, and here this is the velocity over 2, and this is the loss coefficient for different valve and accessories. So let's see here, here you see, go back to, okay, here you see loss coefficient for the faucet is given, loss coefficient for the glove valve, we should go and see the table, and loss coefficient for the elbows. How many elbows? 1, 2, 3, 4 elbows, one glove valve and one faucet. Okay, so go back and see, go back and see how much it is. Okay, so you see this is for the faucet 2. This is the 4 elbows into 1.5 is the loss coefficient. Okay, and 4 okay, and 10 is the loss coefficient for the glove valve, is much more. So the total pressure drop we got in the form of the pound per feet square, and if we convert into psi, it will become 9.17 psi. Okay, so this is for the minor loss. So if we add them together with the major loss, and so it will become 21.3 plus 9.7, it will become 30.5. So the total pressure drop in case of all kind of losses, it will become 30.5. So that means to boost the the pressure at the inlet will be 30.5 psi. To maintain the pressure or the velocity at the exit, okay, 19.1 feet per second, we have to maintain the pressure at the inlet, which is 30.5 psi. If you maintain less than that, you will not get the velocity at the exit. So here you can see, we can analyze graphical representation for both the cases. No losses is the solid line, and the including all losses is maintaining the thin line. Okay, here you can see there is no losses, because here you can see the variation only because of the change in elevation. Okay, here you see the point one, we have the basement. Okay, we have a particular velocity as you are moving up. Okay, the energy is reducing. Okay, the energy is continuously reducing till we reaches here. But here you see at point one, you see the lines are not straight. The pressure drop in the pipe, you can see, because there is no loss in the pipe. Here there is no, this is the pressure drop, you can see this is because of the elbow, and then again there is a pressure drop in the pipe, again there is a pressure drop in the elbows, pressure drop in the pipe, pressure drop in the elbow, pressure drop in the pipe, pressure drop in the elbow, pressure drop in the pipe, and this is the pressure drop in the glove valve. Okay, this is the pressure drop in the glove valve, and then there is a pressure drop in the you can see this is the 0.2 from 8, this is the faucet, so there is a pressure drop in the faucet. Okay, so this is basically the profile. You can see how the profile changes if we consider the losses. So rest you can understand. Okay, so here you see this is the energy grade line. We know that in the case of ideal fluid, if there is no losses, the energy grade line remain straight. Okay, but if there is a losses, so definitely energy is reduces and it consumes due to the friction. Okay, it losses due to the friction. Okay, so as it is showing here, you see this slope is due to the pipe friction, and this is due to the loss coefficient of the elbow. This is loss coefficient due to the glove valve. Okay, so I think you can fully understand. So this is end of the lecture, and this is end of the course also. So if you have any question related to this topic, you can ask me during the live session. Thank you very much. Assalamu alaikum.